I find it a miracle. I mean, it is. I don't pretend to understand it, and I think it is absolutely marvelous that nature somehow thinks like a mathematician. That, of course, James Jeans said that God appears to be a mathematician, and it is astonishing that somehow all these weird mathematical ideas which we have invented for purely aesthetic reasons, essentially, just as works of art, as intellectual constructions, turn up then unexpectedly to be used in nature. I mean, there are so many examples of this, of course. The classic case was differential geometry, which was invented by Gauss for very practical purposes, just for the projecting maps from the spherical Earth onto a plain piece of paper. So he invented this differential geometry as a way of representing curved surfaces on a flat plane. And then 50 years later, Riemann applied that to a description of space and conjectured that space itself might actually be curved. But it was still sort of purely an intellectual hypothesis without any kind of physical basis. And then another 50 years later, it turned out to be the essential tool for Einstein to understand gravitation. It is, in fact, what Einstein used for general relativity. And so it's built deep into the structure of space-time. It's a miracle how that happened. So Gauss had developed this tool for totally other reasons. And that's happened again and again. Of course, Lee invented Lie groups to understand classical dynamics, and it turned out to be 100 years later exactly what you need to describe particles. And I don't know why, but so the world has deeply built into it these mathematical structures, and there seems to be a kind of rule that anything mathematicians can invent, God somehow can use. And so we hope that's also true of the Riemann hypothesis. We haven't yet found the Riemann hypothesis verified in nature, but maybe we will one day.